You're the God of this. I want you to meet a friend of mine that we've met about a year ago, last November, October.
November last year.
And God kind of brought us together, and I want you to hear his story on about how God has been working in your life over the years. And about last December, you and I kind of had a meeting that resulted in an introduction for you that's taken you on a whole new journey or experience with God that sort of opened up the door relationally. And so just want Jim to share a little bit about his life with you.
I was a pure rebel. I had no intention of doing anything but make my way to South America.
I became involved in the revolution down there. And during that time, I was being watched, and I was on a list that the government had. And so after about a year down living in Panachel, I had a group of men came to my hut. I was living out in the middle of the jungle. They had AK-47s and told me to leave the country. So they took my money, passport, and visas, and told me I needed to leave. And at the time, there was literally hundreds of people being killed in that region of Guatemala. So the next day, I sold my clothes. I got six quetzals, Guatemalan money, and I hitchhiked up to the Mexican border. And when I crossed the border, I had a knife and not a dime to my name. When I was walking down the street in Santa Cruz, I saw a man working on a house, and I told him I needed a job and I would do anything, so he hired me. And it turned out he was a Christian in the best sense of the word. He did not kind of force any religion on me, but I just looked at his life that he had something that I wanted, and that was faith and
peace
and a peace of mind. So we had our crew of men. We get together each morning for prayer time, and on Wednesday mornings I'd get up early, meet him at 5. We'd have breakfast together, and you know, share things, what was going on in my life. And he had a huge impact on my life, and eventually we became partners out there. I got my general contractor's license. He moved up and became more of a financial type person, and we had a good business together for several years. We had an experience when we were actually working on Bill's house in Santa Cruz. I was up on the about three stories up on this gable, and we're leaning rafters on up. I remember I was stepping on one, and in the blink of an eye, I went head first over this building. I was down, and like that, I was sitting back up on the ridge of the house. There was, I was not nervous, scared. There was just like peace, and I'm all, you know, I didn't understand what happened. I just kept working. At the end of the day, I shared that with Bill. I said, "Bill, you wouldn't believe what happened." He just started laughing, and he's all, "There's your guardian angel there." Well, I'm not sure if I believe that, but over time, I've been in a lot of circumstances where there's been an inner conscience that has led me in one direction or another, and it's kept me from harm, or it's put me right in the path of you know, meeting somebody that was, you know, meant for me to meet.
Mm-hmm.
So
after that, you kind of going down this life journey, this life road. You meet Bill, then do you meet somebody else?
I did. I ended up going up to Montana, and I was living up there, and I met a young man. Well, my age, I was probably 25 years old. We started working on a ranch together, and he and I had a lot in common. And just something else. All of a sudden, we started talking to him, and he let me know that his Christian faith was real important to him. So he invited me to go to his church, and I was introduced to a lot of young people that were, I felt, really had something that I was looking for. They had some peace. Not that they didn't have troubles, but they really had a sincere love of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I was living over in Europe, and I was in Hungary, in Budapest. I finished a job over there, so I started traveling. I went through Yugoslavia and went down into Greece.
Right.
And I think back, this was a very compelling time. I was going from from island to island, and I was not into the party scene. I just wanted to find a place where I can just get some peace. And I didn't know anything about the Greek islands. So this ferry stops, and it looked like a small island, which didn't look real touristy. So I just got off, and I started hiking up this mountain, and I came to this monastery. And it was really cool. I started walking around, and as I went through the monastery, I went down into the basement area, and there was a cave there. And what I had no idea where this was. All I know is there's a monastery on this island. And I got this incredible sense of peace in this cavern area. And when I went back up and started walking to the monastery, I was told that was the island of Patmos, and that was where John was banished to, and that cave that the monastery was built over is where he wrote Revelation.
Wow.
I was high on life. You know, I got up on these rocks, and I was singing top of my lungs. I ended up like taking my clothes off and jumping into the sea, and I was up there singing at the top of my lungs, and I felt like I was the first man ever there. And then I looked up, and all these people were looking down on me. So I went back to that village that night. They thought I was just crazy, and had a great night there. And you know, the next morning I took off, but with once again I found a place where I think Christ was knocking on my door, because how do I end up in the cave where Revelation was written?
What are you doing now?
I have a construction company here, and so we've been fortunate, been very successful. We've always had good work, but really over the past 2 years, I've had a lot of, I've been really missing some things. I've been meeting some new people with at our children's school, and there was one man in particular, John McClellan's, who I was just drawn to him. So we'd seen each other over about 6 month period, and one day I just felt compelled to approach him and start talking to him. Mm-hmm. He shared with me that he had a group of men that he was meeting with each Tuesday morning, and it was a group that I fell right in with. And it probably after about a month, it hit me that it was time to make a commitment. So I approached you and kind of asked you, how do I commit myself to Christ? And I remember going out to my truck and making that move. And I've never, other than getting married, opened up my heart and trying to give 100% to, I'm ready, Lord, just come into my life. And that's where I'm at now.
Do you remember texting me about 2 or 3 days later? You're going to the airport. Well, you said, Bill, going to the airport in my truck, first time I've been riding in my truck where I feel like I'm not alone. And it was kind of like, that's just what I sensed in you, is that you were just, it's like God wanted to get into your life. You knew he wanted to get into your life. You knew he wanted to get into your life. And it's just a moment where all of a sudden you said, it's almost like dating. And then you go, I really want you in my life. I'd like you to be my wife. And you asked Frida, will you? And she said, yeah. And then all of a sudden you become husband and wife. And
that's how it is.
Yeah.
That's how it is.
You know, Jim is a story of a guy that, God called me to come to Nashville back in 1994. And like God told Paul in Acts, just get up, go into the city, and I'm going to tell you what you need to do that day. And that God has people within cities that he's been drawing to himself. And that's kind of what we do with Search, is we try to be faithful to get up, go into the city, find out who God's working on. And there's a guy like Jim who God's been working on underneath the soil of his heart all these years. And I just had the privilege to bump into him at a place as John McClellan. God used John. And, it's just neat how that's how the family of God grows. That's how the kingdom of God grows, is one man telling another man where he's found some bread.
That's right.
That's it.
Bill, thanks, man.
Yeah.